Hi, I'm Sanjay Nagchowdhury, Development Lead for the IBM App Connect Enterprise product. In this video, I will demonstrate how to get started with using IBM App Connect Enterprise version 13. As in previous versions of ACE, we have a toolkit for developing message models and message flows, a command console for administration, and a web UI for administering your integration solution and using capability like business transaction monitoring. New in ACE version 13, we are providing Designer, which allows you to build flows that require low code and can access SaaS endpoints using event-driven flows or using a REST API. Users of previous versions of ACE will be familiar with a toolkit. It is a powerful IDE which allows you to develop and test message flows and message models so that you can create an integration solution which processes messages. It has a graphical mapper, a debugger, and flow exerciser which allows you to develop and test complex integration solutions. In addition, the toolkit has extensive unit test capability so that you can add automated tests to run in your pipeline. Designer has been available in the IBM App Connect Enterprise as a service offering for a few years now. With the introduction of version 13, we are providing Designer to be used within ACE. Designer allows you to create and test event-driven flows or a REST API which can be run on an ACE integration server. The flows in Designer are completely schema-driven and can connect with hundreds of applications on cloud and on-premise through pre-built smart connectors. Designer is predominantly aimed at business technologists who want to rapidly assemble integrations with low code and using high productivity tools. The toolkit is generally aimed at integration experts who need to create flows which process a variety of message formats across many different transport protocols. In order for a message flow to process a message, the application which contains the message flow must be deployed to an integration server. An integration server is a process which can be started independently or it can be managed by a component called an integration node. By using an independent integration server, you can quickly deploy and test your integration solutions. The integration server can also be used in a container, which you can run in your cloud deployments. If you want to use the integration server locally, you can start it on the command line or from the toolkit. When using Designer, an integration server is started automatically so that you can test your flow. So let's do a short demo of Designer and Toolkit. I will be going into details on each of the new features in later videos. This is Designer. Here it is provided with ACE. After installing ACE, you will see an extra option to start Designer. When you start Designer, an integration server is automatically started for you. This allows you to create your event-driven flows or APIs and test them without needing to understand about starting a server. It will just automatically deploy to the server. So I have already created an event-driven flow and an API. So here is a flow called Git and Slack. And in this flow, I'm using a scheduler node to drive it. I have a GitHub request node which retrieves issues with a label bug. So you can see that here it's accessing my repo and doing a retrieve. And then I have a for each loop which goes through the result set and sends a Slack message for each issue that is found with a label bug. So there's a button here which says test flow. If I click on test flow and select using real data, it will start the flow and you can see it is sending messages to Slack. So if I open Slack, I can see that four issues have been found with a label bug and it has sent a Slack message to my Slack channel. So that was using Designer, and I will go through how to create a flow from scratch in a separate video. So here we have a toolkit, and in here you can create message flows, message models, you can create an integration server, and there is new capability where you can also create credentials, which I'll talk about in a moment. So I have a very similar flow that I just showed you in Designer, where I retrieve the issues from GitHub and send them to Slack. So I can deploy the flow to the integration server using the flow exerciser. I can then send a message to the flow exerciser. And after sending the message, I get a message on Slack which shows me the issues which have a label bug. So a very similar flow and the same outcome. The flow exerciser does have extra capability where you can click on points in the flow and you can see the message at any time, which is being processed. As well as providing Designer in version 13, several other new features have been provided. We have added more discovery connector nodes to the palette. So these are the same connectors that are available in Designer. Each connector issues a synchronous request to create, retrieve, update, or delete a wide variety of objects. The toolkit provides a discovery connector wizard, which allows you to connect to the SaaS endpoint, gather back schemas and policy into the workspace, and store credentials in a vault. The schemas can then be used for mapping in the toolkit. The version 13 toolkit has been enhanced to allow you to manage credentials. You can create an external directory vault or connect to an existing one. A menu has been added, which allows you to create, update, and delete credentials through the toolkit. Credentials can be updated in an external directory vault or in an integration server vault. So let's give a short demo of that. So here I've already connected to an external directory vault, which I created earlier. It has two credentials in here at the moment, one of type GitHub, another of type Slack, and they were used by the flow that I demonstrated earlier. I can right click on the vault and select create credential. I can give it a name, so if I call it cred1, and then I can select from the different types, I can start typing and it will find the types which match the letters that I'm typing. So I've typed HT, I'm going to select HTTP. And then I can select an authentication type, so I'm going to select basic. And if I enter a password and enter a username and then click finish, the credential is added into the vault and that can now be used by your integration solution. A full demo will be shown in a separate video. Another new feature in version 13 is a new machine-wide setting has been added for the automatic enablement of SSL for the administration of all version 13 integration nodes and integration servers. If I type command IBM int display admin SSL, this shows that the installation-wide admin is set to enabled, and it also shows the location of the certificates that have been installed. So by default, when version 13 is installed, the default configuration of a product will be for administrative connections to be secured by SSL, courtesy of a private key and certificate pair. They are self-signed and automatically generated by the product install. So this means that when the integration node or server is started, by default, administration port will be secured. Remote connections using the REST API, including those from the toolkit and the admin web UI, require the use of generated certificates. So let's do a demo of this. If I cd to my home directory, let's create a work directory and call it ace13 workdir. And let's start the integration server. So I'm using a REST API port of 7611 and an HTTP port of 7811 for the HTTP flows. If I start this integration server, you'll see from the output from the integration server that the REST admin port is using port 7611 and it is using HTTPS. So if I try and connect to this integration server, on port 7611, HTTPS is now ticked by default. If I click finish, it is now using HTTPS. And I can still use the usual toolkit actions, so I can deploy an application to the new integration server as usual. And I can start the web UI, and I can select to accept the certificate, and it is now using HTTPS. So another bit of capability we added in the toolkit was to allow you to disconnect from a running integration server or node. So I can choose to disconnect from the integration server. It's now disconnected. And then I can, if I want to connect, I can connect. And the same can be done for integration nodes as well. So in addition, configuration is also available for message flows to use HTTPS without users having to do anything extra. ACE will generate the key and certificate for the HTTPS connector to use if it doesn't have its own explicit key store configured. So this means that you can deploy flows that have the use HTTPS box ticked without having to configure the HTTPS connector yourself. A demo of this will be done in a separate video. So let's move on to the next new feature. So these are improvements in IBM Int. So let's remove this connection. And let's just stop the server for a moment. Okay, so if I type IBM Int, we have a number of different commands that can be used within IBM Int. All of these are documented in the IBM documentation. For example, you can select IBM Int display supported GRE versions. And as you can see, we now support Java 17 as well as Java 8. So the default is Java 17 when ACE is installed. If you do need to go back to use Java 8, you can by using IBM Int specify JRE. We also have other new options. So for example, if I type IBM Int set, we have capability to set credential, set mode, set admin SSL, and set HTTPS connector SSL. We also have options for IBM Int unset. And we have options for import and export as well. And this allows you to import credentials and export credentials from the vault. Another useful command is to display credential types. So if I type IBM Int display credential types, I can see a list of credential types and I am told whether a credential type is dynamic or static, which leads me on to the next new feature, which is that a number of credential types are now dynamic. And the ones of most interest are the MQ credential type is now dynamic and the ODBC credential type is dynamic, which means that you can change the credential of that type without needing a flow restart. Another new feature is a new node called JSONATA mapping node. And this has been added to facilitate generating a JSON message to send to a backend. For example, a file or an MQQ, or perhaps you might need it to be used so that you can send a response message for a REST API. Let's give a short demo of this. We'll do a full demo in a later video. I have a schema for the response that comes back from the GitHub request node here. If I add a JSONATA mapping node here and wire up the out terminal to it and add the schema, so it's found the response schema of the GitHub request node, I'll click OK there. And now if I configure it, it will use the same UI that is used with the other discovery connector nodes. So I can add a property and I can say issue number as the property name. And if I click on edit mappings, I can select the value from the GitHub request node. And if I select issue number there, I will get the array of issue numbers that are returned labeled bug from the GitHub request node. So if I save that, that will construct the JSON message, and if I write it to a file, so if I search for file and select the file output node, and let's select the directory, GitHub and Slack directory, let's copy that and use that as the value of a directory, and let's put a file out, so let's call it issue number dot json, and let's save that. If I now run this flow again, I'll redeploy and put message through. Message has gone through and the file's been written, and if I have a look at, if I refresh this, I can see the file's been written and I can see the issue number there. Another neat piece of capability we've added is the ability to open a terminal in the toolkit. I can cd to a directory, and I can cat the same flow, which is useful. I also have access to all the usual commands. So, for example, I can type IBM int, and I get the output from IBM int. So, another useful addition to use the console here inside the toolkit. A full demo of JSON item mapping will be done in a separate video. Another new capability is that we have provided a new patterns gallery. So you can access this from the menus or from the welcome page. So if you click on patterns, then it opens up the patterns gallery, and there are a number of patterns that you can choose to install and then create an instance of. You can also select different patterns by selecting a tag, and it finds those. Or you can select on specific categories which you want to see. And a demo of using a pattern will be done in a later video. So in this video, I've given an overview of some of the new features in ACE version 13. Full documentation for the new features is available online. We will be providing further videos which demonstrate each new capability in further detail.